Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have freely sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous soul. Therefore, I ask that the Mary, Mother of Virtue, all angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, praying for me, the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Pardon the faults of your servants, we pray, O Lord, that we who cannot please you by our own deeds may be saved through the intercession of the Mother of your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Reading from the Book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Send men to reconnoiter the land of Canaan, which I am giving the children of Israel. You shall send one man from each ancestral tribe, all of them princes. After reconnoitering the land for 40 days, they returned, met Moses and Aaron, and the whole congregation of the children of Israel in the desert of Haran at Kadesh, made a report to them all, and showed the fruit of the country to the whole congregation. They told Moses, 'We went into the land to which you sent us. It does indeed flow with milk and honey, and here is its fruit. However, the people who are living in the land are fierce, and the towns are fortified and very strong. Besides, we saw descendants of the Anakim there, Amalekites live in the region of the Negev, Hittites, Jebusites, and Amorites dwell in the highlands, and Canaanites along the seacoast and the banks of the Jordan.' Caleb, however, to quiet the people toward Moses, said, 'We ought to go up and seize the land, for we can certainly do so.' But the man who had gone up with him said, 'We cannot attack these people. They are too strong for us.' So they spread discouraging reports among the children of Israel about the land they had scouted, saying, 'The land that we explored is a country that consumes its inhabitants, and all the people we saw there are huge, veritable giants. We felt like mere grasshoppers, and so we must have sinned to them.' At this, the whole community broke out with loud cries, and even in the night, the people wailed. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron, 'How long will this wicked assembly grumble against me? I have heard the grumblings of the children of Israel against me. Tell them, by my life, says the Lord, I will do to you just what I have heard you say. Here, in the desert, shall your dead bodies fall. 40 days you spend in scouting the land. 40 years shall you suffer for your crimes. 1 year for each day. Thus you will realize what it means to oppose me. I, the Lord, have sworn to do this. To all this wicked assembly that conspired against me, here in the desert, they shall die to the last night. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Remember us, O Lord, as you favor your people.
Remember us, Lord, as you favor your people.
We have sinned, we and our fathers. We have committed crimes, we have done wrong. Our fathers in Egypt considered not your wonders.
Remember us, Lord, as you favor your people.
But soon they forgot his works. They waited not for his counsel. They gave way to craving in the desert and tempted God in the wilderness.
Remember us, O Lord, as you favor your people.
They forgot the God who had saved them, who had done great deeds in Egypt, wondrous deeds in the land of Ham, terrible things at the Red Sea.
Remember us, O Lord, as you favor your people.
Then he spoke of exterminating them. But Moses, his chosen one, withstood him in the bridge to turn back his destructive wrath.
Remember us, O Lord, as you favor your people.
Alleluia, alleluia. A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people. Alleluia.
Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon, and behold, a Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But he did not say a word in answer to her. His disciples came and asked him, "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed from that hour. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Po at sa inyo po, mga kapatid kumpani, magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Hayaan niyo pong simulan ko ang aking pagbabahagi sa pamamagitan ng isang maikling kwento. Meron daw pong isang estudyante na gustong-gustong pumasok sa Williams College. Yun po yung kanyang dream college. Ano po? Nagpadala po siya ng sulat, application letter, but days later, he received a rejection letter. Pero hindi po siya nasiraan ng loob. Instead, ang ginawa po niya, nagpadala po siya ulit ng sulat, replying to the letter, to the rejection letter, stating, "I reject your rejection." Days later, tumawag po sa kanya yung official ng college. Ang tanong sa kanya, anong ibig mong sabihin sa sinabi mong, "I reject your rejection"? Ang sabi po noong estudyante ay, "I reject your rejection. I am going to your school. I don't care what it takes. I'll take a year off. I'll take classes. I'll do community service. I'll meet with anybody. I am coming to Williams." At nang dahil po sa kanyang sagot na iyon, nakapasok po siya sa Williams College, and now he has become a noted entrepreneur and a noted author. The point of the story, persistence. Persistence, according to Oxford Dictionary, is the firm continuance of an action despite difficulty and opposition. And in our gospel for tonight, the woman exhibited persistence. We have heard in our gospel for tonight that she was rejected 4 times. The first instance was when Jesus did not say a word in answer to her request. The second instance was when the apostles asked Jesus to send her away, for she kept following them. Marahil po noong sinasabi ito ng mga alagad kay Jesus, naririnig niya, "Paalisin niyo, paalisin niyo naman po yung babaeng iyan, at siya po ay laging sumusunod sa atin." And the third instance was when Christ said, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." And the fourth, and I believe the most painful rejection, and also a sort of insult, would be when Jesus said, "It is not right to take the food of children and throw it to the dogs." She is being equated to a dog. But despite these rejections, the woman answered, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of his masters." And because of her answer, of her response, Jesus said, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed that hour. The woman's persistence together with her faith was rewarded. Connecting persistence with the various topics shared with us by our speaker, it is very timely that we ask ourselves, have we been persistent in being a sacrament of Christ's priesthood? Kahapon po ako'y nakatanggap ng isang text galing po sa isang youth. Binati niya po ako ng Happy Priest Day. Meron pong kalakip na quotation from St. John Mervenet. Ang quotation po ay ganito, "The priesthood is the love of the heart of Christ. When you see a priest, you think of the Lord Jesus Christ." Out of nowhere, ako po'y sumagot. Ang tanong ko po, "So nakikita mo sa akin si Kristo?" Nag-reply yung youth. Sabi niya, "Konti." Sabi ko tuloy sa sarili ko, siguro artista ang iniisip nito kapag ako'y nakikita. Siguro si Bumble Moran. Have we been persistent in being a sacrament of Christ's priesthood? Secondly, brothers, have we been persistent in realizing our promises of simplicity, obedience, and celibacy? Ito po yung aking, kahit na po ako ay kaka-ordained lang pong body noong June 11, ito po yung aking pinagninilayan ngayon. If I live up to my promises during my ordination, the promises of simplicity, obedience, and celibacy. And the third question that we may ask ourselves, have we been persistent in being reflections of God's perfection and mercy? Ano po? Dahil ngayon po ay taon ng Maranatha, I think it is a great opportunity for us to really exert effort to show God's mercy to people. So as we continue our Eucharistic celebration this evening, let us ask God persistence in our priesthood and ministry. As parting words, brothers and sisters, I leave you the suggestion of Israel Mor Ayivor. Si Israel Mor Ayivor po ay isang youth leadership coach and also the author of Daily Drive 365. Ano po ang suggestion niya? Sabi po niya ay ganito, when resistance closes the door against you, remember that persistence holds the key. Don't give up too early. Insist to endure to the end. You will never regret it. From his book, Daily Drive 365. May God bless us all.
Jesus Christ tore down the barrier separating Jews from Gentiles. As one people of one new and eternal covenant, let us pray to the God who unites us. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church throughout the world may become a channel of God's mercy, peace, and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as community of believers, we may not be divided by petty barriers of hatred and prejudice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That mothers who are anxious and deeply worried about their children's health may never fail to turn to Jesus for support and comfort. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may show care and concern for suffering people, regardless of their status, race, or religion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have departed from this life may rejoice forever in God's heavenly home. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, our refuge and our strength, your wish is to unite all people. May we always be sensitive to the needs of others and never exclude anyone from our company. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you look on the loneliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with yours in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Giving thanks that you have kept us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Ray, the Bishop of his diocese, and Benaventura, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to sing. Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. our celebration has been offered, go forth to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.